And welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity, The White March, Part 2. Blind, I am the RPG chick. Heading now. Well, we gotta click on this. Let's go into sneak mode, actually. We're supposed to be sneaking.
Be constant.
Yes, constantly cautious. Now headed to the Abbey of the Fallen Moon. All signs point to there. Two quests. Well, three quests, including Maneha's little personal quest. We have to sneak in there. You know. Let's rest. Alright. There's camping supplies back here. Are those the remains of the eyeless? Oh. These are from men. I guess who fought the eyeless? Oh no. This binding copper and vessel flesh is from the eyeless. Okay. So guys, just want to grab one of those. God, it's the size of them. They're gone. We destroyed them. What were those things? You saved us! Again! My god, the humanity! Let's go. What's this one? Oh, okay. And this has that helmet. Iron flail. Right. This might be the fastest way. Yes, come with us, Skull.
Nice and quiet.
Come with us nice and quiet, like. Here we go, 15 hours. Hireling payday. Long Bosc? Where's the Short Bosc? Greetings.
So, you said the eyeless came from the Abbey.
Right. We're gonna talk to Long Bosc now.
I'd heard rumors of the eyeless, but I always thought that name was a metaphor.
No, they literally do not have eyes. It appears they never had eyes.
Though, I would have called them Mace Hands of Doom, if anyone had asked me.
That's a good one, too. I like that. Mace Hands of Doom. That's why they didn't ask you? How rude. Nod noncommittally. Their name doesn't matter. They'll fall by my hand all the same. Badass answer.
See, this is what I like about you.
You like the badass, yeah, don't you?
So this is the mysterious army you've been dreaming about, huh? It's a wonder you're getting any sleep.
That's why we're going to the Abbey. To stop them.
I'm regretting all of my decision-making up to this point.
Yeah, huh?
Still, I guess a suicidal plan is better than none.
I thought you'd be happy. You've been looking for the Abbey a long time.
I know, it's just...
She grumbles with exasperation. I love the voice actor for her.
Well, knowing that I'm finally close to getting rid of this memory, it feels like it's crowding my head that much more.
She paces and locks her fingers into her hair.
It's been with me for decades. Driven me halfway across the known world.
She throws her hands up. And? She stops pacing and sighs.
It's time I told you what I did.
Take your time.
It was a war. Centuries ago, before Adirin unification.
She folds her hands in front of herself.
I was a soldier then. Led a campaign across the northern forests to subdue some of the outlying Kalklin villages. Brutal work.
I understand. What war?
This was 500 years ago, when Adir was a folk kingdom on one side and elven country on the other.
Oh. How long do Amawa live again?
They fought on and off before they joined. Now the folk and elven rulers marry to keep the peace.
Okay, go on.
Right. The campaign. Lost a third of my forces to the forest, and another third to the elven scouts hiding in it. By the time we reached the first village, we'd crushed their defenses, and they'd bled us.
She shakes her head.
Wasn't much more than children and the elderly left. But they spit on us when we marched into town.
A scowl twists her face. Her eyes are cold.
The village elders surrendered and offered us lodging in the old meeting hall. And when the sun set, they tried to burn it down around us.
She closes her eyes.
They barely got a flame going, but that wasn't the point.
What was it?
In their defiance, I saw months more of pointless, bloody battle as we fought for the rest of the region. I had to break them. And I had to send a message to the rest of the villages.
Her hands shake as she raises them to cover her face. Well, she really regrets what she had to do.
So I nailed every last one of them to the trees around the town and left them there to die.
Damn. Not gonna pass judgment either way, just yet. What happened then?
I never remembered more.
She shrugs.
Eventually, Adir and Kalklin united. The gentlefolk forgave each other for what they'd done to each other's people.
You've got no reason to hold on to a memory from 500 years ago.
So I've tried to tell myself. Anyway, we should get going.
She shoulders her pack, and you catch a glimpse of something unusual in it, a thick roll of cloth bound by leather. What's that?
Something I've been saving for better days.
She tucks it away. Anything else she will answer? Same questions. Okay. It's all for now. Does anyone else want to talk? No one has the icon here, but let me just check. He's just talking about theirs.
Hey. What's on your mind? What?
I'm ready. Need something?
Okay, nope. No one has anything to say. Okay, now we can talk to this Long Bosc? Oh, what's going on here? See, that bothers me. Canna is assigned. It's still remaining two turns. Well, this is two, this is three. Let me just see if it progresses. If not, it's stuck, and he's really not assigned. Who knows, it may have completed already. I don't even know. Oh, right, right. Are we still... This is another thing that keeps undoing itself. 2 days for the training grounds. 4 days for the South Curtain Wall. Let's do that. It'll be done quicker, and then we'll work on the South Curtain Wall again. I don't know if it's supposed to keep resetting like that, or if this is just maintenance we have to do. I mean, it would make sense if it's maintenance, but then just say so. Grab the flower. Hello, Long Bosc. A dwarf, clothed in but a few straps of fur, puffs up his bare chest with every drag from his pipe. Come a long way to get some air, have you? What are you doing here? Enjoying the fine weather. Just a bit longer. He smiles, letting a cloud of smoke and frosted breath escape through his teeth. You don't get cold at all? My mistress had business with the Andrites. We'll be off, soon as she's done at the Abbey. Meantime, I was told to stay put. They don't want any outsiders meandering about. She's already put some kind of hex on me. Says I won't even remember any of this. But the copper's worth it. I thought it was your old lady. She says I'll wake up at home with a full coin purse. Opposite of most of my mornings, but so that had a certain appeal. Oh, his mistress, yeah. Tell me about your mistress. Which one? He slaps his chest. A reddening print blooms on his skin. Wish she were the fun kind. She's a gift bearer. Paid me well to guard her on the journey, though. I'm looking to get inside. Are you now? He pulls the pipe away from his clenched teeth and points its long stem to the path ahead. Far as I know, straight this way. The middle path on the right, with the ruined arch. If they let ye in, of course. Andrites are none too friendly but to their own. My mistress went through the archway, spoke to some guards there, then headed on. He bites down on his pipe with a sour expression. They got eyes on the other paths. Cast me dirty looks from afar when they pass this way. He grunts. As if I'd stand here in plain view if I had some grand design of sneaking into their blazing church. And what's an abbey got that's worth hiding, anyway? Monks? He grunts again and shakes his head and mutters something about if he were younger. Do you know of other ways into the abbey? No, but it's an abbey, not a fortress. You can bet it's got holes, like any fat old monster. Supply passages, escape routes. He shrugs as if it were a matter of course. I'd be lying if I said I'd never explored one uninvited when I was too young to know better. Help myself to its relics. Let's just say if a certain war goddess has her way, I'll be living my next life as a dung roll bug. Why are you helping me? He shrugs. You got a look about you. Look like you need it. And maybe there's something I don't like about this place. Like it's hiding something. In my younger days, it'd be me going in there. Very well. Doubt we'll meet again. Any luck, my mistress will return soon. Hope you find what you're looking for. The abbey is well guarded by Andrite monks. They will have to be dealt with or slip past. I ran into the mercenary escort of a gift-bearer. He believes there are several ways inside the abbey. He said his mistress spoke with some guards beneath a broken archway who let her through. I think try another way other than the archway.
Time to see and not be seen.
Goes for all of us. So what'd he say? The one to the right? The middle path on the right.
Got it.
How many paths are there? Okay, so this path? And then this goes somewhere else. Maybe an alternate way in?
Hard to imagine a whole sect living out here. But I guess that's the point.
We've reached the Abbey of the Fallen Moon. Maneha believes the salt well is here somewhere. When we find it, she'll be able to wash away the memory that haunts her. We need one of those, men in black, you know, things. Look at the
Even our visitor is to be turned away, he said.
What interest would our quarters hold?
Our quarters aren't the worry. It's our brothers and sisters below.
Andre, Tidal Fist, and Mind Gazer. Interesting. Interesting names. Well, they ran off that way. The middle path to the right. Let's head this way then. Should we talk to him? I don't want to fight all these people. Hold! Who's there? I don't know. I don't think you believe me if I say this. I don't think I look like a Tidebringer. I was just looking for the way out. You were trespassing here. Oh, crap. I was just looking for the way out, man.
Join up.
You go no further? Sounds like he was saying join us. Alright. Knock him down. Go no further. Well, I guess we're fighting our way in. Punch it, Margaret. Detonate him. Oh, crap. That's me. I got thrown all this way. Kill those something or other.
Thing isn't doing their job.
Oh, knocked him down. Is he? He's not locked to anybody. Okay, can we just withdraw him? Since he's the wizard and everything. Maneha, yeah, do your barbaric shout.
Attack!
We are attacking. What do you think's going on? We need help. Okay. He can just heal. There's no one. Oh, that's Aloth. Yeah, he's in the middle of all this crap. There's only two of us that really need it badly. One of us can heal herself. And it looks like no one's paying attention to her right now. Adair, you need to get up. We both need to get up. Let's see if we can get a heal off. Durance and Maneha. Let's do the jump thing. Dragon leap. Boom. Oh, sheesh. No! Can't get around. Hit this guy. Like that. And this is... You knock him down.
Hey.
And knock him down.
Join us!
Join us, huh? Alright. That means Aloth had a critical hit put on him. Andre Tidal Fist Mask. I'm wondering if you all put on these masks. Paladin Helm. Monk outfit. Exceptional sword. What kind of shield is that? Exceptional medium shield. What if we all sneak in with these masks and monk outfits? Of course we need more of them. Regular cape. Fleet feet. What is this? Wizard's double.
Whew, good thing I sold most of my jewelry.
Doesn't seem like that can be good for sneaking, having that go off all the time.
No problem.
Should we continue up this way or go see what those guys are about? Let's go this way. A fine mace. Girdle of mortal protection. We have some of those and some moonstone. A couple of us have those girdles. Alright, let's quick save. Because that was... goes up. It's like frame rate hits. Giant skeleton's leg. Oh my. A coppery sheen glistens under the layers of ice that hang around this giant femur with the colors of a rainbow. Here's a Tidal Fist dude. Right. Yeah. Ranged. Not even slowing him down. The guy doesn't even have a shirt on. And now this one. Hello there. How you doing? Palagina. Slacking off? Another mask. The monk outfit. Potion of minor regeneration. Not really helpful. Fine warbow. Okay.
Laying low.
Sure.
Looking for this well also. Giant skeleton's leg. let's head back this way. This is where the dwarf was hanging out, right? I mean, maybe we could find one path and stick to it, but I'd like to explore it. Plus, we have to find this well. I can't actually look at that. Okay. Andre Crescent Ward. These guys have cool names. I want to be an Andre and have cool names like that. Crescent Ward. And Tidal Fist.
Let's try that.
Intruder! Stop! Never. See, it seems to target Aloth as well. Like it has to target someone else. That stinks. I'm trying to hit just one person. I just want to hit one person. I don't know. It's gonna hit me too. I don't know. Aloth engaged in melee. Okay. 50 crow damage. Okay, he only hit. It didn't hit him. Okay. Is he already knocked down? I can't even tell. He is. Call you Dead Fist now. He's getting a lot of critical hits on him. Exceptional sword and large shield. Here's another monk outfit. Another mask. Potion of Eldritch Aim. Some Sveff, why not?
Eyes are peeled.
Your eyes are woof, woof. We should rest. Stop that crap as well. Nope, guess not. Didn't stop it. I guess that's how many points he got hit with a critical hit. At least now it's daylight out. Look at that. You stand at the precipice of a fissure that time has torn into the mountain upon which the abbey stands. Whistling winds call out from the depths of the crevasse. Mournful wails, hinting at the great descent from the edge into the dark and lonely spaces below. Sorry, guys. Encased in centuries of time, a gargantuan skeletal hand hangs awkwardly above the gap. Its fingers are splayed in a pained pose, ice preserving the circumstances of the victim's death long after the flesh rotted away. With only the ominous moaning of the crevasse to disturb your thinking, you consider your options. Well, there's not many options. We can inspect or leave. Let's inspect the area. Considering the span of the gap and the position of the skeletal hand, you believe a well-placed grappling hook would allow you to reach the other side. Though positioning the hook may be tricky, the winds are not so strong that they would endanger attempts to cross. All right, let's leave for now. I want to explore more of this area.
I'll see what's ahead.
So will we all. This is ahead. A sworn sword. Here are our sworn arrows, sworn sword.